Øskroner.
Hi, Jeff Lees here from Husqvarna Australia. Just like to give you a bit of an overview of the 2017 TC250. This bike's had significant changes. Primarily, it's got an all-new lightweight engine design. This new motor, aside from being a lot lighter, this new engine actually has reduced vibrations, and that's achieved through a new balance shaft system, which is a bit of a game changer there, really cutting down on the vibrations of the bike. The guys at the factory have really worked hard to get some pretty serious weight savings in these new bikes. Starting here with the new subframe, it's made up of 30% carbon fiber. This new subframe adds a lot of rigidity to the bike, and it kind of interacts with the frame to get the right flex characteristics. Another beauty of this carbon subframe is that if you take a bit of a tumble, this frame or subframe can flip back into shape quite easily, unlike an alloy subframe. So there are some real benefits. The actual all new chrome moly chassis, it's designed to have certain aspects of flex in it to improve the ride characteristics of the bikes, reduce the vibrations that come back through the handlebars, and just give you a much nicer feel when you're taking those big impacts and big compressions. Tying in the frame to the engine part of the bike is an all new head stay system that you can see right here. It's much wider than the old one, so it's working a lot better in kind of working in with the engine to kind of stiffen the chassis up a little bit. Probably one of the biggest features on these new bikes is the all new air fork system, all new for 2017. This new air fork is 1.6 kilograms lighter than the old spring system. One fork is carrying the air on the left hand side, and then on the right hand side you have your fork which has the rebound and compression dampening in it. These WP forks are quite different to our Japanese counterparts in the way that they're designed and put together, and essentially with this particular design it's virtually impossible to lose all of the air through a seal failure. It's got an enclosed air chamber system, which I think is a very smart feature, and obviously rider safety is improved significantly through these new forks. Once again, we talk a lot about flex on the bikes. It's got an all new triple clamp system here, which is wrapping around these tubes here and really optimizing the flex characteristics so the whole front end works in harmony. That pretty well sums up the main changes to the bike. There's a lot of nice little details as well. The OGI lock-on hand grips, which are a really great feature. Got the Gura hydraulic clutch system here, standard on the bike. Got a really nice new gripper style seat here, and obviously, you know, finishing off the bike, we have all new bodywork and graphics, which I think makes this bike one of the smartest on the market.
I'm Glenn Carney from the Husqvarna Enduro team here in Australia, and I'm just going to do a quick overview on the new 2017 model year Husqvarna Enduro bike. Starting here up front, we've got the new WP 48mm Explore fork, which has adjustment on the top of the fork here, compression and rebound, which is toolless, along with the new feature of the toolless preload adjustment where you get the range of 0 to 6mm adjustment on there. Also got the new traction control feature on the handlebar on the left side, where you've got the standard mapping, also an advanced map on the bar, and traction control on both maps. Alongside that is the new Magura clutch, which is just for ease of use and a great product on the bike. We've got the new ODI lock-on grips. Moving further back, we've got revised engines on both the four-stroke and the two-stroke. which are all lighter and produce more horsepower. Holding that is a revised frame, which has better flex characteristics and better handling for an overall better ride. We've got the new bodywork that goes on that. You've got the single piece side plate, which is better for stop hang-ups with boots and knees and things like that. Flat gripper seat on there. Under the seat is the new lithium ion battery, which saves a kilo over the old battery. Revised shock and linkage setup on the rear for better handling also. You've got new self-cleaning foot pegs to stop the mud getting stuck in there. So as an overall package on all the bikes in the enduro range, we've saved anywhere from 1.5 kilos up to a massive 6 kilos on some of the models. So all in all, a premium product ready to get out and race or ride just for fun.